going on, everybody? I'm glad to be here tonight. How y'all doing out there? A little rough and rugged this day, but nevertheless, we here. Huh? Let me come up and speak. Who we got? What's up, everybody? How y'all doing? All right. We finna get ready to rock and roll tonight. Interesting topic. Nevertheless, it's gonna be good. Now let me slide up so y'all can see. I can see some of these. Yeah, y'all give me 1 second. Let's groove out. Hey, invite somebody to be your virtual guest right now. Say, hey, come join me tonight. We're in a series called You Asked For It. Thank God that you're here for another Tuesday night. Let's get ready to go all the way around tonight. Yeah, I'm excited tonight. We're going to have a good time. We got a couple of minutes before we get started. I'm going to give everybody the opportunity to invite somebody to be their virtual guest tonight. Hey, how y'all doing out there? Listen, y'all asked for this tonight, so I'm going to teach you. We're going to talk about it, share a couple of things, and then we're going to move on out of the way. Hey, baby, can you give me a napkin, please? Again, thank God for all of you tonight joining us. God bless you for joining our midweek PT service. This is where we get together and we go through God's word for the building of our lives and our spiritual walk with Him. And we want you to be our virtual guest, along with the partners of COP tonight. Is that all right? Appreciate it. Yeah. All right. Listen. For the sake of time, I'm going to go ahead, excuse me, and jump right into what we're going to get into tonight. I want to give a disclaimer. As soon as we jump on tonight, I want to give a disclaimer. There are going to be a lot of opinions tonight concerning what we talk about. I do want to have an open dialogue at the church. I was going to do this for members only so we could dialogue and all of that good stuff as I was looking at some things and all of that good stuff, but I need everybody to just hold your comments and we're going to talk. We're going to have a good conversation a little bit later. But I want to lay a little groundwork tonight. I won't be before you long because I didn't rest much this weekend. I got a little lazy Saturday, Sunday afternoon. But I guess I'm so used to getting up early Monday, I was up. So I'm still a little blowed out from the weekend, but nevertheless, I guess that may not be the term to use tonight, but nevertheless, we're here. So I want to thank God for all of our partners tonight that are here. Thank God for all of the partners in Olive Branch, Mississippi, Savannah, Georgia, Birmingham, Central Florida, also Auburn Opelika. Thank God for all of you all. God bless you. Every partner that's here in the Tri-City area, God bless you all. Thank you so much for tuning in to your PT service. I want to thank God for my wife and my children, all the staff here at the Church of Purpose, for everything that you do. Listen, let's go real quickly. I'm finna tie this disclaimer in here real quick. It's finna be a lot of reading. I'm finna read you about 23 verses, but I need you to hear it before we talk about what some people put in that box. So I need y'all to listen to what I'm about to read to you from Romans 14. I'm gonna read it out of the Good News Translation, all right? And I'm doing that for teaching purposes, okay? All right, verse 1. Everybody got it? Send me a thumbs up. If you got a smart device, go to Good News Translation so you can read along with me. It said, "Welcome those who are weak in faith, but do not argue with them about their personal opinions. Some people's faith allows them to eat anything, but the person who is weak in the faith eats only vegetables." Excuse me. "The person who will eat anything is not to despise the one who doesn't, while the one who eats only vegetables is not to pass judgment on the one who will eat anything. For God has accepted that person. Who are you to judge the servants of someone else? Is it their own master who will decide whether they succeed or fail? And they will succeed, because the Lord is able to make them succeed. Some people think that a certain day is more important than other days, while others think that all days are the same. We each should firmly make up our own minds." Hear me now. "Those who think highly of a certain day do so in honor of the Lord. Those who will eat anything do so in honor of the Lord, because they give thanks to God for the food. Those who refuse to eat certain things do so in honor of the Lord, and they give thanks to God, who do not live for ourselves only." We do not live for ourselves only, and we do not die for ourselves only. "If we live," watch this, "it is for the Lord that we live, and if we die, it is for the Lord that we die. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord, for Christ died and rose to life in order to be the Lord of the living and the dead." I'm going somewhere, y'all. I told you, this is my disclaimer. I'm as we set this up. "You then, who only eat vegetables, why do you pass judgment on others? And you who eat anything, why do you despise other believers? All of us will stand before God to be judged by him, for the scripture says, 'As surely as I am the living God, says the Lord, everyone will kneel before me, and everyone will confess that I am Lord.'" For y'all that read King James, "Every knee is going to bow, and every tongue is going to confess." So y'all know what I meant. Verse 12 says, "Every one of us then will have to give an account to God. Whether you don't eat meat, or whether you don't do this, or whether you don't do that, and you say you serve God, no matter what you say you do and what you don't do, everybody has to give an account to God. I don't eat chitlins. I don't like tomatoes. But just because Brother Edda eat them don't mean I got the right to say you wrong for that, or you shouldn't be doing that. And chitlins are dirty and yada, 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 all that good stuff. All right? Now, as we move over into the next theme of Romans 14, which is verse 13, the theme of these scriptures is do not make others fall. So let's listen to what Paul is now saying as he let us know, hey, if this person do this and they serve God, they do it under God, let God deal with them. And that judgment, that's going to be between them and God. It ain't my job. Okay, so now Paul comes down and changes the theme. Do not make others fall. Look at 13. "So then, let us stop judging one another and say it." Watch this. "You should decide never to do anything that will make others stumble or fall into sin. Or other words, make someone miss the mark by what you believe and by what you have your own opinion about between you and God. You should never make anyone else fall by that. My union with the Lord Jesus makes me certain that no food of itself ritually is unclean. But if you believe that some food is unclean, then it becomes unclean to you. Catfish nasty. They bottom feeders. We shouldn't eat that. Well, we shouldn't do this. We shouldn't do that. Okay, if that is your dedication, that's between you and God. I don't eat catfish. I just don't like the taste. But if I did, I don't want nobody coming to tell me that I'm going to hell for eating a piece of catfish that I believe God done blessed and I'm finna eat. Okay? Don't make me fall all because you feel it's not right. Or I got, watch this, or I got to come to your standard. Because at the end of the day, let's remember this, your opinion, your decision, at the end of the day, it's going to be you and God at judgment. All right? Oh, it's going to get good. Oh, y'all hold on. For if you hurt others because of something you eat, then you no longer are acting from love. Do not let the food that you eat ruin the person whom Christ died for. So me and you got bad blood all because catfish. All because you think you should do this, and I don't think you should do that, and I don't die, and now we at odds, and somebody falls, watch this, because what we debate over what we think God wants. Do not let the food that you eat ruin the person from whom Christ died. Look at 16, y'all. It's getting good. I got about 8 more verses. Do not let what you regard as good get a bad name. Let me bring this to church 101. I pray every morning at 6 o'clock. Well, I pray at 10. But that don't mean I'm wrong. And that don't mean you're right. That's between me and God. Well, you know what? Swine nasty. I'm coming, y'all. Just hold tight. Do not let what you regard as good get a bad name. For God's kingdom is not a matter of eating and drinking, but of righteousness, peace, and joy, which the Holy Spirit gives. If you got to fuss about it, you're not in right standings. One thing about me, and anybody that know me, I'm a fan of Mr. Boosie. Why? Not because of the music, because he says what he means. And he means what he says. All right? Verse 18, and when you serve Christ in this way, watch this, you please God and are approved by others. Now, verse 19, so then we must always aim at those things that bring peace and that help strengthen one another. Do not, because of food, destroy what God has done. I done died for everybody. The ones that eat this, drink that, go here, go there. I done died for everybody. Let me work them out. Watch this in my time. All foods may be eaten, but it is wrong to eat anything that will cause someone else to fall into sin. In other words, it's wrong to delight in anything that will cause someone else to fall into sin. The right thing to do, as Paul says, is to keep from eating meat, drinking wine, and doing anything else that will make other believers fall. So in other words, what I'm saying is, if Brother Sam at the house, and he said, you know what, I don't eat steak, I'm not going to come to Outback with a big steak to his house, sit in front of him, cutting a piece of red meat, knowing that it has the potential to offend him. All right? I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to make him fall just because I eat meat, red meat, and he don't. And I come to his house, and even if, and because of peace, even if we went to Outback, I would order chicken just to keep peace. All right? Because it's about peace. Verse 22. Listen. Keep what you believe about this matter then between yourself and God. Happy are those who do not feel guilty when they do something they judge is right. But if they have doubts about what they eat, God condemns them when they eat it because their actions is not based on faith. Listen, God condemns them when they eat it because their action is not based on faith. And watch the clause of this. And anything that is not based on faith is sin. So whether we do this or do that, if we don't do it in faith, we ultimately miss the mark anyway. So in the You Ask For It box, somebody wanted to know about drugs and alcohol. So I told y'all, You Ask For It, I was going to teach on drugs and alcohol. And hear me out. I used to drink. That's why I got this little gold glaze on my eyes. If you ever get up close to me, I got a little gold glaze on. And before I come out here, anybody that done seen me pregame before I teach or preach, I'm putting Visine in my eyes every time before I get. Because watch this. When I, pre-salvation, that was my thing. But watch this. Even though I did it, I didn't do it around somebody that didn't because I did not want to offend them. And I wasn't even saved. All right? Because I wanted peace at that time instead of you preaching to me about what I should be doing and what I should not be doing. So what I did was, even though I drank because I wanted to and went where I wanted to and felt how I wanted to after I did it, watch this. If Brother Sam was already a saved young man and him and Brother Eddie coming by the house, you know what I did? Hey, how y'all doing? Hey, nice to meet you. Good to see y'all. Appreciate it. Y'all have a blessed day. You know why? Because of peace. Now we don't have to dialogue and fight over what I'm doing and what you're doing. Because watch this. Nobody knows where nobody is or anybody is in their walk with God. So there's a chance you can meet me while I'm taking steps to get to him. And judge me before time. So I want to show you something in 1 Corinthians 6 and 12. It says, all things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any. I'm going to read the same verse to you in a different translation. Listen, I am allowed to do anything. I'm a grown man. You say, my answer to this is that not all things are good. So even though I'm grown and I can do whatever I want to do, the question is it good for me to do? Listen at this. Even if it is true that I am allowed to do anything, watch this, I would not let anything control me like a slave. Case in point for me, I messed around when I started working for New Millennium in 05. I seen everybody coming to work and they had coffee cups. Everybody sitting around drinking coffee. You know what I did? I got me a coffee cup, Kurt. And they, who wasting hard coffee all down the hall? Coffee? What I didn't know as a coffee drinker is as long as you don't look at the coffee, it ain't going to jump out. You can pull it to the rim and just walk. And as long as you don't look at it, it don't jump over the side. But the moment you start focusing on it, it starts to spill everywhere. I said, yeah, it's me. I clean it up. But watch this. It's 2021 now. And if it ain't, if I hadn't had a cup by 9 o'clock, my head go to bumper. You know why? Because even though it's lawful, I've become a slave to it.
Yes, that's good.
Because now it makes my body say, hey, boy, it's 9 o'clock. Waking up. Folgers in. Ain't no Folgers that hit your cup yet. Water don't do it. Hot green tea don't do it. Coca-Cola, Sprite, ginger. Lord knows I love ginger ale. But if I could pop one early in the morning, it still ain't going to do, watch this now, what I've allowed myself to be bonded to. So what I'm trying to tell you is, it's lawful for you to go and do whatever you want to do in certain cases. But the question is it good for you? And watch this. What you're doing, is it faith-driven? So this is what I tell you. If you can continue to shoot up in the presence of God and do it in faith, keep doing it and watch faith pull you out of it.
Go ahead.
I just killed two birds with one stone. Somebody just said, oh my God, Pastor Fred condones shooting up. No, I don't. What I'm telling you is, if you can do it by faith, keep doing it. Because it's faith that's going to deliver you. But watch this. Anything that you're doing that's not by faith, it's sin. Lady A took me off for the weekend and had me sleeping in a cold hotel room. I did it by faith, though. But listen. Listen. So, no, I don't condone shooting up. I don't condone that. But if a person do it and say, you know what, one day, I got a cousin right now. Couldn't stop snorting cocaine. Went to some classes, didn't work. Went to jail over it, just was looking totally depleted. One day, he stuck a picture of his son on the wall. His mom came in, stuck a picture of his son on the wall. He said, this is a true testimony. He said, cuz, I would look at that picture and get high. But all the while, I'm saying, one day I'm going to be a good father for him.
Go ahead.
And then he starts saying, God, give me a mind to turn around. Give me a mind so I can be a father to my son. And watch this. Without a 10-week program, without none of that, watch this. Faith came and made him whole.
Go ahead.
I ain't touched it since. And I ain't talking about just every once in a while. I'm talking about in there. But watch this. He did it. And by faith, he said, Lord, I don't want to be this way. I don't want to do this. Make me whole so I can be a father to my son. And then he'll hit a land. Rails, hit him. But watch this. Because of faith, the Lord now has did everything he's petitioning for. Married, beautiful family, driving trucks, got his son raised. His son. I'm talking about beautiful. By faith, though. I remember riding with him one day. I said, and he was a preacher of the gospel. Man, I said, you are a preacher with issues. And you need to reconnect with God. And I promise you, he'll do everything. Which leads me, watch this, to 1 Corinthians 6:19-20. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you? Y'all remember that lampstand I was telling y'all about Sunday? Where does it reside? In you, which ye have of God, not of man. Can't nobody put it there. The Lord himself breathes it into us as we receive it. And ye are not your own, for ye are bought with a price. What's that price? When Jesus shed his blood, any opinion you have can fall under the blood. Whether you think it's right or whether you think it's wrong, it can fall under the blood. And if you allow the blood to do its part, when you stand before God, all will be well. But watch this. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Now, someone asked about drugs. I'm going to hit this real quick. Drugs are a substance that changes a person's mental or physical state. They can affect the way your brain works, how you feel and behave, your understanding, watch this, and your senses. This makes them unpredictable and dangerous, especially for young people. The effects of drugs are different for each person, watch this, and each drug. Pastor Fred, what about drugs? 1 Peter 5 and 8. You're not going to see the word crack in the King James Version. You ain't going to see the word cigarette in the Bible. A lot of this stuff, you won't see a lot of that stuff in the Bible. But watch this. You got to have a God conscience to understand what he's saying. 1 Peter 5 and 8 says this. Be sober. How can you be sober on drugs? When I just told you, drugs are substances that change a person's mental and physical state. Be sober, be vigilant. Why does the Lord tell you to be this way? Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Lions are not the fastest four-legged predator in the jungle. They're actually kind of slow compared to the cheetahs, panthers, and things of that nature. They're actually slow. On top of that, they have small stomachs. So if you ever watch National Geographic, you understand when you watch them eat, they have a whole lot of leopards and hyenas come eat it because they don't have big stomachs, so they kill big prey. But watch this. They don't even eat it all. They leave it for the stragglers of the jungle. Why would the Bible use an adversary as the devil and use it a parable and look at him as a roaring lion? That's why I had to ask myself. Why do I need to be sober and vigilant? Because the word devil comes from a Greek word, diablos, which means one who throws repeatedly. He's going to keep coming. That's what the devil's job is. He keep coming. Repeatedly. Always. That's why the scripture says, resist the devil. When you resist something, you have to continuously hold your stance because there's a repeated force coming. Resist him, and why is it? Eventually, he has to flee. Because lions aren't as fast. They have a paralyzing roar, though. So when they open their mouths, it paralyzes its prey. But watch this. If you're sober, my sheep know my voice. I don't scream. I talk. So there's a lot of times we can get paralyzed in fear. And watch this. It gives him time to catch up to us. That's why we can't be on drugs, because it takes our senses away from us, not understanding that the lion is roaring. He's steady coming, but watch this. If we are not in our right mind and our physical state, he's getting closer and closer every day. And watch this. He don't want all of you. He just wants a big chunk of you, and then he'll let everything else devour you up. So watch this. When they finally get there, they got enough power to knock you down. That's what that first lit do to you. It's strong. It changes the taste buds. And it gives the body a crave. See what I'm saying? So the other imps can come and piece by piece. Every time I, it takes a piece of me, watch this, away. And he slowly devours me. The approach of a lion. Do I really need to keep going with Drew? I don't really need to do that. Now we get to the drinking of wine. And I got to remind myself of what Paul said. And I'm going to be truthfully honest with you. As I studied, I didn't see anywhere where it told you you couldn't drink a glass of wine. But I want to bring into the question of your motives for doing so. That's my job. Because I knew my motive. I ain't drank wine. I was Paul's son, man. Christian brother. He ain't sad. I had a little money. And then when I felt uppity, I drunk a little grape, a little Belvedere with a little, you know, cranberry juice on the side. So listen to me. I haven't been saved all my life. That's why I teach the way I teach. I wore this shirt tonight because I wanted to make some people mad. I can't believe Pastor Fred got a Nipsey Hussle shirt on. But you got Nikes on and they got a whole gay pride line. I did that to say this. No one can take their opinion and stick it at the front.
Go ahead.
You see what I'm saying? Now y'all see where I'm coming. Nobody can take their opinion and stick it at the front of the line. Because at the end of the day, if God gonna get me for repping Nipsey Hussle, that's between, watch this, me and God. But watch this, through the lampstand, if I'm wrong, that should be a conviction that shows up. So as you read John 2, I'm behind time, so I'm gonna have to, John 2, 1 through 8, it talks about turning water into wine. The odd thing is, they're at the party, and by Jewish culture, they drunk wine. When you look at the culture throughout the Bible, they drunk wine. But they also drunk it to the point where they got married. You know, it wasn't just, you know, no, they drunk it till they got married. And why is this? Nobody talks about the Jews were the chosen people. These were the Jews saying, hey, we out of what? The chosen folk were hollering. And Mary said something. She said, hey, Jesus, you know, is a woman. And what got me, he refers to it, he said, woman. In other words, that distinguished, you're pulling me over into my calling. It's almost like a parent when their kid know how to dance. Come out here, baby. Show everybody what you do. Come on, come on. Mom, I don't really want to do that, man. Come on out here and show everybody. Come on, do it. Do it one more time. Say your ABC. Y'all hear that? That is so cute. And she said, hey. She didn't even wait for Jesus' response after that. She just started talking to the disciples. Whatever he tell y'all to do, y'all just do it. I said, at the end of the day, it's going to be right here. What I call into question, though, he took the water pots, filled them to the brim with water, turned them into wine. The parable goes on to say that the man said, hey, man, usually you bring the good stuff out at the beginning. Why? Because once I get you drunk, I can give you the watered down stuff. I hit you real good when you first get to the party. Now when I got you, I can save all the nice balls and I just pour you some scraggler stuff and save that for the next party. He said, behold it, you done brought out the best wine at the end. What drinker you know, as you drink, it tastes better as the night goes on. Because what I just told you was, your senses have a tendency to go as your sobriety goes. That's why ugly women look pretty when you're drunk. Ugly men look good when you're drunk. I ain't talking about nobody. I'm just saying, you know. Because your senses now are not calibrated. Stuff that you wouldn't usually hear and listen to and entertain and even speak on, but a drunk man's secrets. A sober man's secrets is a drunk man's conversation. Because now, I know with me, when I hit that mark, hey, I'm there, you know. Here's my question. It takes 2 to 3 weeks for something to ferment. Somebody would say, well, hey, Jesus. It came through for a minute. Let's set this up so we can make a statement. I'm challenging. Anybody know me? I want to hear everybody's opinion, but I also like to challenge you because it should teach me something. So let's challenge this theory. Fermentation is the chemical breakdown of a substance by bacteria, yeast, or other microorganisms, typically involving or giving off of heat. The process of fermentation involved in making a beer, wine, and liquor in which sugars are converted to alcohol. If it was fermented, my question to challenge your thought process tonight, why would Jesus continue to give them something to get them drunker when they were already drunk? Because the root word of fermentation is the word ferment, which means to incite or stir up trouble. So when grapes hit the bottom, I ain't a problem with them. It's when you let them sit there and stir themselves. Now you got trouble in a bottle. That's where I think it was fermented. James 1 and 13. Let no one say when he is tempted, I am being tempted of God, for temptation does not originate from God, but from our own flaws. For God cannot be tempted by what is evil, and he himself tempts no man. So if you're already drunk, you think I'm going to help you get on there? What they tasted was purity. Let's look at the parable behind it. What they tasted was purity. That's why it has such a different taste that even a drunk man, his natural senses can understand this is not natural. Mm-hmm. Well, Paul said, I can drink a little wine for my stomach, because Paul frequently had an illness with his stomach.
Go ahead, break it down, Pastor.
Can I challenge? Can we challenge? Can we talk? We just talking. We just talking. What's that? I would argue that if it was for the stomach, okay. But it never said anything about a hard day.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
It never said anything, man, I'm depressed. I'm oppressed. Man, my mind just running. Paul never said, when you had a bad day, pull out your Stella Rose. For me, I never drunk that sweet stuff. Again, I was a PM type guy. I didn't drink that neither. I was a Christian brother. Didn't even know I was coming into it though. But that's not my opinion. That's my opinion. So if somebody, Pastor Fred, what you going to do if you're at the table and somebody would you get a glass of wine? I ain't going to do nothing. I'm not going to do not one thing, because at the end of the day, that's between you and God. If you drink it in faith, that's between you and God. I'm not a Nazarite. I never pledged that I would never drink, because I love my edge line too much. That I need an edge line. So I never made that vow to be a Nazarite. Okay? So I would challenge. Paul told Timothy, stop drinking only water and use a little. How many? My stomach hurt. y'all may think it's funny, but I'm showing you my opinion. Martin's. Again, we just talk. We just talk. My opinion. But again, if you can drink it in vain, that's between you and God. Pre-salvation, I'm gonna drink me some. I didn't drink wine. That just wasn't my goal. But as I came over into the faith, I learned how to cast my cares on God instead of pouring it in a glass. Lord, you take this instead of saying, how am I going to fix this? Proverbs 23:31-32 says, look not upon the wine when it is red, when it giveth its color in the cup. I got to see if this thing ferment. Just right. When it moveth itself, all right. That's why they call it spirits. On the east side of town, it's ABC store. But on the west side, it's called the spirit store. When it moves itself, all right. We there. But watch this. At the last, it biteth like a serpent and stingeth like an adder. In other words, it sneaks up on you and bites you, but by that time, it's too late. Habits are nothing more than appetites that got out of control. All right? But again, what I'm saying to you is, if you can continue to do, or I can continue to do, because here's the thing. We're talking drugs, alcohol, but what's the difference between chicken wings? Mm-hmm. You know you fool, but it's so good. It's the same thing. But watch this. In church, we have a tendency to put stockings. Y'all know how we do. Y'all know how we do. But there's no difference. And knowing, you know what, I need to get up from here. I'm full now. But no, we just are no different than, hello? Man, guess what I just heard? You ain't gonna believe it. I don't supposed to say nothing, but. So my question is, what's your alcohol of choice? Because all sin sneaks up like an owl and bites. So I didn't come here to pick at nobody. Listen, if you drink wine with your meal and whatever, if you do it, if you can do it in the presence of God and in the faith of God, that's between you and God. Because when, again, Romans 14 say, when you and him look eye to eye, I hate the day I'm going to have to look at God with gold eyes. Because I stayed at the bar too long. When he made them pretty and white. That's me. That's my opinion. So I said all that to say this. Anything we do without faith is sin. Any questions, anybody? Okay. So now I know we're going to have a lot of people in there. That's what we want. We want you. I want everybody to think about what they do. I've been thinking about everything I do on a daily basis. Not just this kind of, on a daily basis. Why do I do what I do? Am I doing that in faith? Again, all things are lawful. Me spending all this money on joy, but how is that making the gospel go any farther? So literally, I'm a slave to something that can't really win nobody closer to God, or it's going to get me closer to God. But it's lawful, though. I can spend as much money as I want on sneakers. But it's a help for Satan. When I look at my closet, I'm like, dog.
Yeah.
When I look at Drina's purse, I'm like, dog. Yeah, I ain't gonna be out there by myself. I ain't gonna be out there. Hey, watch this. Did I buy these out of faith, or did I buy them for fun? You see me? So now, this is bigger than just drugs and alcohol. We want to start looking at everything. Am I doing this? Are the conversations I'm having on the phone faith-driven conversations? It's going to get me closer to what God really created me for. Or is it going to have me looking at somebody else different? Girl, I heard about you. Now when I see you on Sunday morning, this morning, no. You should come, y'all. Hey! But watch this. That's what tarrying at the phone do. So we ain't got no room to talk at somebody that tarry at the bottle when we can't stay off the phone. So again,
all that we do, if we don't do it in faith, watch this. We miss the mark anyway. So the thing is, whatever you do unto the Lord. Can I make it any more plainer than that? Because I'm self-evaluating everything now. Even down to the people I'm connected to. The people I'm giving time to. Your time with me increase my faith? Or you taking me back a couple steps? Messing with my senses, because our senses are what keep us tied to the world. That's why you can close your eyes, smell something, and say, that's that. But then get to church, because we're so sensual, but we can't smell the sensual flavor of the Spirit when it comes into the house. You don't smell that which you know. Your spirit got to feel that. Now it's heavy when we lift our hand, watch it, because we done had fun and hadn't checked what we're doing according to faith. All right? Everybody good? All right. With that being said, it's time. I got to listen to my boy here since he done died. All right, listen. Right now, you have the opportunity to worship God in the aspect of giving. All right? We got three ways that you can do so. Number one, money sign, COP, the number four, the letter U. All right? Second, cash and or check. Please, if you do so, fill out your envelope so we can get you your appropriate printout at the end of the year for your tax return. All right? Lastly, Pastor Brad, I love you. I love the Church of Purpose, but I ain't down with that COVID. Cool. Mail it. 3124 West Main, Suite 8, Dothan, Alabama, 36305. All right? Right now, this is the time that you can worship God and give Him. Look at Saved by Get Head on that one. Come on, come on. Sleepless night and so much pain. Can't see nothing but rain. But we can make and do it for tonight. In the morning, you'll be alright. Let me stop messing with y'all, man. We have our regular announcements, right? Nothing. Please. Due date, listen. If you're going to make it to the pastoral ordination in Birmingham, you have to turn to our church members page and fill out that form. Because we got to turn them in, and we need to let them know in advance so they can make room for the people. Yeah, and if you are going, we'll send you a link to fill out your COVID form, all right? All right? I know a lot of people may not want to go to a bigger city with COVID. I understand that. It will still be live. I was going to take a coach bus, but I thought about it. I said, a lot of people sitting on here, and I ain't ready to ride that bus by faith. So if I can't do it by faith, Kurt, I ain't getting in it. So, with that being said, I know the precautions that I take. So, I didn't want to put nobody's health at jeopardy. So, if you're going to go, I'm asking that you team up and ride together. I would love to see as many COP family partners as we can, but I understand if you can't make it. I promise you, I understand. All right. We can have a meetup place. We can all trail each other like a big old caravan and going up there. All right. With that being said, are we having tomorrow? Tomorrow we do have our kids ministry at 6 o'clock, Zoom. Also, there will be an update for our youth ministry. As soon as Sister Kim gets me that, I will get that to her. Get that to you guys. And with that being said, I think that's everything, man. This Sunday, y'all. This Sunday, we having testimony service. I ain't preaching this Sunday. I ain't teaching this Sunday. We're going to testify. And hear me good. I ain't going to be no preaching. If the Lord ain't gave you a word to prophesy, ain't going to be no prophecy. Ain't going to be no laying on hand. We're going to testify. All right? We're going to share what the Lord has done. Attest that he was on the money. In other words, came through. That word money comes from M-O-N-I-E, which means on time. All right? Attest when he was on time that I get to tell. All right? So bring your testimony with you. Let's get it fiery hot. Ain't nobody had no questions on there, did it?
Jeremiah Stonehorn. Same time. Oh.
Yeah. All right. Listen, I'm sorry. I'm past my time. I supposed to have been done almost 20 minutes ago. But I had to kind of set it up. Go back and read Romans 14. So if you're strong in the faith and God done brought you above some of this stuff, bless God. But don't make nobody feel like this because they're still taking steps to get to where you feel God has you. All right? So, with that being said, stretch your hands this way. Father, we thank you right now. We thank you, God, that you gave us another opportunity to worship you in the aspect of tithe and offering. We ask, God, that you bless it for your kingdom agenda. Now, God, as we leave this place, but never your presence, I ask that you cover each and every partner of COP. Lord, allow your spirit, God, and your hand to cover us in the midst of all sickness, hurt, harm, danger. Steady the hand of the enemy, God, that COVID cannot cross through that the blood has bound. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I will see you guys on Sunday morning, 9 a.m. Pastor Durbin, please call me. Shoot me a text or something. I want to talk with you and your wife about getting y'all down here to bless our spirits one Tuesday night. Hey, I love you guys. Tell somebody you love them. Let them know they are purpose-driven. Until Sunday, good night.